me? Can you hear me?
All right.
Oh, Lord. Give me about 7 minutes. I'm not going to finish this message today. Give me about 7 minutes. I'm going to give you just a snapshot of what I feel like the Lord is saying, and then I'll finish it up next week. Look at somebody and say, it won't fall. It won't fall. If you have your Bible, turn with me to Matthew chapter 16. And it's Matthew chapter 16 and verse 18. Again, that is Matthew chapter 16, verse 18. If you're on Twitter, tweet. If you're on Facebook, Facebook, whatever. We just want to make sure that people know what exactly is going on here. That you may not in here just kicking it. We are here worshiping God and having an encounter with Jesus. If you have Matthew 16 and 18, I'm going to be reading to you out of the Amplified Bible. And it reads like this. It says, and I tell you, you are Peter, Greek, which it means the Petros, a large piece of rock. And on this rock, the Greek, the Petra, a huge rock like Gibraltar, I will build my church in the gates of Hades. The power of the infernal region shall not overcome it or be strong to its detriment or hold out against it. I'm asking you, O God, today, that as I preach your word, that just even a snapshot of this message today, I ask you, O God, that the people of God receive something in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, in last week's message, I did a message entitled, What's Our Foundation? And really what I wanted to do and try to stress was the point that the church's, this church's foundation is to be built upon Jesus Christ, not even as me, the pastor. And I believe that so many times in churches, we have made the church about the services and we have not made the church about the goal, which is Jesus. I need you to understand this, that the goal of the church is to show the world Jesus. The goal of the church is to show the world Jesus. That the goal of the church is not just for exciting services, not even just to make you feel good, but the goal of the church is to show the world Jesus. It is that as we take on what God has called for us to do, then we become a living, breathing reflection of Jesus Christ, our Lord. And so in Matthew 16, 1 through 5, the Pharisees and the Sadducees came up to Jesus asking him for a sign to prove himself. They literally were antagonizing him so that he can prove exactly who they thought he was. And so the first thing I want to say to you this morning is this. Don't spend time trying to explain yourself to people who are bent on misunderstanding you anyway. Don't spend your time trying to explain yourself to people who are already bent on misunderstanding you anyway. There are people in this world that they care less really about what you do or what you think. Really, a lot of times there are some people that just want to antagonize you. They really don't care about what you think. They really don't care about your heart. But I need you not to spend your time trying to explain yourself to people who are bent on misunderstanding you anyway. We see here in Matthew chapter 16 that the Pharisees and the Sadducees spent all of this time trying to get Jesus to prove himself by doing miracles. Explain why he did this. Explain where he came from. And Jesus was like, you know what? If you really want to know who I am, go look in the book of Jonah. He literally was like, go in the world. Go find it out. Go search it out for yourself. But I'm not going to spend my time here trying to explain to you who I am. I know who I am, so why do I need to prove to you who I am? And some of you guys have got to a place in life where you're locked into this people-pleasing syndrome, where you spend all of your life trying to prove to people who you are. And I'm here to say to you today, quit trying to prove yourself to people and learn how to be a reflection of Jesus. Yeah, so quit, man, just quit it. Just quit it. Just some people you just need, you just don't have an answer for. Well, why do you do that? Why are you still going to this church? Why are you still doing it with all the rumors, all the gossip, all the stuff that is going on, all the rebuilding that has to happen? Why in the world is they doing that? Why don't you go somewhere that is easier? Simply just don't have an answer. I'm learning in this season, I just don't have an answer. I'm just doing what it is God has called me to do. I ain't got to explain myself to you. I know what God has called me to do. Did you call me? Did you make me? Did you fashion me? Did you spend all the time that God spent on me to make me who it is I'm supposed to be? So I owe you nothing but to love you. So all y'all need to do is just love folks. Just love them. But don't spend all your time trying to explain who you are to validate who you are. God has to take care of that. And so the disciples were warned here in verse 6. Let's read it. Jesus said to them, be careful, on your guard against the leaven, the ferment of the Pharisees and the Sadducees. I'm sorry, this is Matthew 16 in verse 6. Matthew 16 in verse 6. He says to them, be careful and on your guard against the leaven of the Pharisees and the Sadducees. Literally what he did is he warned them to guard themselves against the leaven of the Sadducees. He basically is telling them to be very careful of who you're listening to. Because be very careful of who you're listening to and what you're listening to that would cause doubt to grow in your mind and your heart about following Jesus. You might have some people in your life that might be speaking and saying all kind of stuff, and they might be saying a bit of truth, but a little leaven messes up the whole lump. And the reason why so many people are confused about where they're supposed to be, where they're supposed to go to church, what they're supposed to do is because they're listening to too many voices that are not the voice of the shepherd. Jesus said that my sheep know my voice, and the voice of a stranger they will not hear. And I'm learning in this season of my life how to be a sheep. I'm learning how to say, oh God, I want to hear you clearly. I can't listen to all the mess, all the gossip, all the stuff that people have to say, and I got to learn how to listen to the voice of the shepherd, because I know if I listen to the voice of the shepherd, I won't be led wrong. This is why I'm staying in my word, man. This is why I'm keeping my face in the book, to understand what it is God has to say. God, what are you saying? What do you feel? What are you saying? So be careful, man, who you're listening to, because a lot of the doubt that you might have in your mind is because you're listening to the wrong people. Yeah, we can thank you for that later. And so the Pharisees and the Sadducees are a type and a shadow of religious people in our day. These are people that say all the right stuff, but they don't operate in the spirit of love. And they seek to expose and pull others down for their own gratification. You can tell when a person is operating in the spirit of the Pharisee or the Sadducee because they say all the stuff that sounds right, but love ain't there. You don't seek the fruit of the spirit: love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. You don't see them operating in the character of God. All you hear is them saying what they think indeed is true. But you must understand this, that if you're going to be what God has called you to be, you have to learn how to quit listening to the haters, listening to the naysayers. You have to learn how to listen to Jesus. And so believe me, I'm alive just like you. I'm not dead. Yes, I walk in the spirit, but I also am alive. And I see the shots that are taking at me. I've seen the shots that are taking at the church via social media. I hear the same rumors you hear. I hear the same gossip you hear. I know the same people who ain't hearing, who's supposed to be here, who don't want to be here. I hear the same stuff you do too. But the one thing I've learned is this: I don't have to receive them. And the reason why I don't receive them, this is huge, because I have the revelation of who I serve, who I am in Him, and who I am called and what I'm called to do for Him. I have this revelation of who I serve. I have this revelation of who I am in Him, and I know what I am called to do for Him. See, man, would you understand those things, then what people have to say about you no longer matters, because I've learned that I have to do it for Him, I have to do it with Him, and I know who I am in Him. So here in verse 7 through 11, I'm fast tracking real quick for you. The disciples think that Jesus is fussing at them because they didn't bring any bread for the journey. They thought that because they didn't bring any bread for the journey, that Jesus is fussing at them about not listening to the teaching or the leaven of the Pharisees and the Sadducees. And Jesus was literally discerning their thoughts, and He began to say to them what they were saying to themselves. And God began to remind me of the miracles that He did here at the club. I seen here that in Matthew chapter 16, Jesus began to bring them in remembrance of what they saw through Him. He said, do you remember the 5,000 and how many people we fed? Do you remember the 7 loaves and the 4,000 and how many baskets you took up? He began to bring them in remembrance of the stuff that He had done while they were able to see it. And God began to say to me, Antoine, do you remember all the stuff that you've done in Equation Church? Do you remember all the stuff I've allowed you to see, all the outreaches you guys have been a part of, all the lives that have been changed as a result of the ministry? It says sometimes you have to remember what drew us here instead of listening to the people who are telling you to pull away. I'm talking to you like a shepherd this morning. But you got to learn how to remember what drew you here and quit listening to the voice of the people that want to pull you away. Because if those people are not under the voice of the shepherd, then guess what? You can't listen to them. It's very dangerous. Let me tell you this to you. I'm going to go ahead and just put it out here for you. It is very dangerous to listen to leaders that won't submit to another leader. It is very dangerous to listen to people who will do the work of the church but not serve in a church.
All right.
brother with me this morning. It's very dangerous to listen to people who will do the work of the church but not serve in a church, because God has an order and a protocol by which he has called for us to do it. And I'm telling you, man, you better be very careful, because what may look like a shepherd might be a wolf. And some of us are listening to the wolf, and that's why I'm using my rod and my staff, because I'm trying to get you to understand that a sheep will lead you to the word of God. It won't lead you outside of the word of God. It won't lead you outside the gates of the local church. But what it will do is help you support and submit to the progress of the local church. So Jesus was saying to them, man, y'all need to be very careful of what you're listening to, because a lot of that leaven that you're listening to from the Pharisees and the Sadducees is wrong. They don't have a spirit of love. All they're trying to do is pull you away. And so in verse 12, the disciples finally got it, and Jesus was like, I'm not talking about bread. He was talking about the teaching of the Pharisees and the Sadducees. I want to put this on the screen for you here, and I'm probably going to have to stop. Sometimes your biggest opposition are the ones who are supposed to be in your corner. Sometimes your biggest opposition are the ones who are supposed to be in your corner. I've learned in Equation Church, I want to say this, and I just might as well close here, that our opposition isn't the lost. Hear me good. Our opposition isn't the lost. Our opposition are the people who are claiming to be found. It's the church people who say that they know the most about what is happening here, but what happens is this, they don't learn how to encourage us to reach the lost. So what God told me was this, that there are some people that are claiming to be found, but they're really lost, because they're pulling people outside of the context of the local church. And so it's not the fact that the lost don't want to be found, it's the fact that the people who are claiming to be found are lost. And so you got me to understand, like, you got to be very careful that the people that God has called us to reach are still there. They have no idea about what's going on because they are lost. It's the people that are found that we have a problem with. So be very careful of the Pharisees and the Sadducees and the ones that think they got it all together and they really know. Because at the end of the day, they don't know. If they're not preaching love, they don't know. If they're not preaching peace and trying to be a mediator, they don't know. If they're not trying to lead you to Jesus but lead you to work, then you don't understand that they don't really know. But how many people really know? They know that, man, I know that there are people out here that got things to say. They don't agree with what is going on. But the one thing I do know is I'm called to do what God has called me to do, and the gates of hell will not prevail. I'm going to have to pick it up there next week. Give God a hand praise. Dang, I want to finish. Oh, the gates of hell will not prevail against the church. So understand this, that some people that you may feel like are blessed in your life might be a curse in your life. That probably some of the reason why we're not able to move forward is because of our circle. Some of us just need to look around and be like, you know what, you are nothing but a detriment, you're negative, you don't care nothing about me, you're not trying to push me to peace nor unity, all you want is drama. I'm sick of the people that want drama in my life. If all you want to do is fight about something, go somewhere else. I need people that want peace, that's striving after peace, that's striving after growing up in the things of God, that's learning how to be mature, tired of all the mess and all the talk. Grow up and do what it is God has called you to be. Look at your neighbors and grow up. Grow up. Give me one more hand of praise, everybody. We'll pick it up next week.